Did it again, and he wasn't available.
Oh! Wanted back to action as they trade. With a right, they both fired a right, and Fan landed his.
That uppercut is very deceiving from Aung Lee. He throws it like he's throwing a straight right, but then he curls it under at the last moment and comes through your guard. Very tricky with that right uppercut, but a beautiful combination right there from Fan Rong to go to the body.
Yeah, dig into the body, Fan, the man from China.
I'm not sure if you guys have noticed or not, but Aung Lee has now switched to conventional. He's back to southpaw. But he was in conventional for quite some time. It wasn't just a momentary switch. He stayed in that stance for a good minute, minute and a half.
Yeah, he's playing almost a time thing, right? Every couple of minutes or a minute or so, he switches the stance. And it's hard to get a read on it, but Fan Rong's doing a good job of controlling his footwork and continually circling to whatever side Fan Rong's, Aung Lee is dominant in.
Blood coming from the left eye, streaming down the left side of the face of Fan Rong, who said this would be a 50-50 match. There are no advantages for either fighter in any area. That was Fan's take on this fight going in.
Fan Rong's definitely showing some improved stand-up, Rich.
For sure, and all this is coming down to the footwork. This is new footwork that we haven't seen from him before, the ability to negate that distance. Normally, he would allow his opponent to come in and then kind of negate that with his wrestling, but this time he's managing it with range.
Right hook and a left up top from Aung Lee, and Fan returns fire. Minute to go, round one. Again, the bout judged as a whole. Aung Lee in the red gloves, Fan Rong in the blue gloves.
That was a nice counter right hand landed by Fan Rong to slide out of the way and then come right back with it.
Another example, Fan Rong using that footwork. Aung Lee committing big to the body shot there, committing big to that last one, and that's what allowed Fan Rong to land that counter.
So here's the deal. Fan Mitch is showing the damage, but he seems to be winning this first round.
Well, he's scoring successfully, and a lot of it's coming off that lead hand. Like you talked about in your keys to victory, the feints, right? Like he's pawing at that lead hand just to give Aung Lee Sam just a little bit of a distraction. Nice little lead uppercut there as Aung Lee starts to smile at him and move forward.
Yes, this lead hand is coming in as a straight jab. It's coming in as a little punching uppercut. Oh, he's rocked.
Two huge lefts from Aung Lee. Can Fan survive the round? Looks to have his wits about him here in the final 10 seconds.
Aung Lee is usually a lot more kick heavy. I'm wondering why he's choosing just to box with Fan Rong.
Uppercut from Aung Lee, and there's the bell.
Agree with you on that. And there was a time before in this round where I thought Aung should throw his left kick, and he did, and it landed. Each time he's thrown that left kick, it's landed really well, been effective.
Prime Video is talking sports Monday to Friday live from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. on Sports Talk. Tune in for new and diverse hosts talking about the biggest sports stories of the day. All sports, all day, only on Prime Video.
Let's take a look at that first round. Here's this right hand that comes right down the middle. Boom. Touches Fan Rong right on the side of the head. It was a beautiful shot landed by Aung Lee, and that's what did the damage to that eye, opened the cut. But a beautiful, look at that, pull back right hand, went right down the middle for Fan Rong.
Yeah, it was that first one, and Aung Lee comes in here and lands another one. But most of the time when he's landing combinations, it doesn't come without some sort of counter that he's paying for it himself. Aung Lee is making big commitments with his footwork on this, and that's what allowed Fan in that first highlight to slide back and come back with that counter. He's got to figure that out, solve that puzzle, because the lead hand, that hook, is what's giving him the fits.
The bell in round two.
But I like the way Aung Lee finished that round, coming forward, throwing heavy shots, showing some confidence of the former champion.
High kick from Aung Lee there to open the second. Fan willing to stand toe-to-toe and trade with Aung Lee, the former world champ.
Yeah, Aung Lee likes the southpaw stance, Rich.
Absolutely, and that last left kick was a nice left hand was a nice left hand that he threw there. Aung followed up with his footwork. You see there, he did it again, and he wasn't available. Both of them landed right there.
Fan rocked him with the right.
Aung Lee works for the wear, though. There's the first takedown attempt. Sits Aung Lee down.
Fan with a single.
He's got a choke sunk in here.
Yeah, but that's probably... He's kind of going for a...
He's tapping!
That's all!
What? Aung Lee making Fan Rong pay for the shot. With a modified guillotine. Gets the tap in the second round, Rich.
Got himself a guillotine using his body to create the angle.
Kind of came out of nowhere. You felt like Fan have the advantage, but...
Well, it did come out of nowhere. Even Mitch at that point was like, yeah, but because he doesn't normally typically quite have the angle. The Fan Rong crowded himself. Aung was able to keep the body in tight, creating that pressure in the neck.
Didn't even have the hooks, didn't even lock the legs in. Just wrapped up the choke. Kind of reminding everybody why his nickname is the Burmese Python.
But the choke finished once they actually fell to the side, and that's what gave him the ability to hold on to the legs.
Were you surprised by that tap? Didn't it sound like...
Yeah, I was 100% surprised. Aung Law has got a squeeze on him to get that sunk in so deep with the improper position. Fan Rong looked like he was going to be okay, but immediately started tapping. What a finish.
I just got to say, Mitch, I wasn't surprised. They called the Burmese Python for a reason.
Wow. Wow. See, I said, Jeff, that's my fault, Mitch Chilson.
He threw me the softball.
Circle side with the Dragon, Mitch Chilson, former ONE fighter, and then Hall of Famer, Rich Ace Franklin, ONE Fight Night 10. And for the particulars, back inside the ONE Circle for Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Herb Dean, has called a stop to this contest after 48 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of guillotine, Aung Law!